Story that you heard first right here on Eyewitness News. And tonight, an investigation is underway. With the latest on that, let's get right to Eyewitness News reporter Joe Holden live in media for us. Joe?
Good evening. The big question tonight is why, and state police are examining that after allegations came forward. Complaints were made by this 15-year-old male student that he received a concoction of not only that toilet water, but also a mix of urine.
A 15-year-old Pencrest High School student is still sick after state police say two 15-year-old girls gave him a drink laced with toilet water and urine. It happened on school grounds around 8:30 in the evening on May 7th. The victim a few days later made a complaint to investigators. Sources claim he has since suffered from an E. coli related infection, a direct result, we're told, of drinking the foul cocktail.
That's disgusting. It disgusts me as a parent.
Reaction to news of the state police investigation ranged from disgust to people wanting to know more.
What do you think should happen to the people involved?
I mean, they definitely should be punished, but I don't know if charges are necessary. I think it's probably like a harmless, like a prank. They probably thought it was a prank, but it's kind of hard. They don't want their lives to be ruined.
State police are proceeding with an aggravated assault investigation, which remains active. No charges have been filed against the two 15-year-old girls, though sources tell CBS3 the school did discipline the pair.
It's very sad what the youth is doing today to other students. It is. It's very sad. You can't even trust drinking a bottle of water.
Should they face charges?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah, the students, yeah.
Well, and if charges are filed, that clearly remains to be seen. All that state police are saying is that they are still investigating this as a case of potential aggravated assault. In the meantime, we reached out to the president of the Board of Education here in the Rose Tree Media School District. We also spoke to the superintendent by email. She would not comment on any accurate or inaccurate statements made to state police, and a no comment on any of the alleged behavior concerning these students. And as far as the Board of Education president, he never got back to us. We're live tonight outside the high school. I'm Joe Holden, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Joe, thank you for that.